Well, the amount of chatter we've got going on over is an indication of the amount of dialogue we're going to have over the next couple of days. It's going to be a great forum. My name's Chris Penfold. I'm Chair Person of our local Native Rights Resource Group. It's great to see some of that in this here as well. I'm just going to introduce our MC for the 2 days, a great friend of mine, Graham Brookman, who along with his wife Anne-Marie run the food forest on the Paul River, that's outside Gawler. Graham's got a huge passion for sustainability and all its tenets. He's promoted for many, many years the education of thousands of people. So they do their courses, their field days, and that sort of thing, which is incorporated and give introduction to the wonderful native species we have in this country as well. So he's a logical one to be running such a forum as this. He has a huge capacity for the extraction of information from people, but also the promotion of information as well. So I'm sure that those capacities will be put to use in the next couple of days. So Graham?
Yes.
Thank you.
We will try to extract a bit of information from you, but I'm sort of painfully aware that the government has kind of dropped a lot of the kind of outreach services, and it's fallen to a lot of you people that are individuals that are sort of really striving to make a difference in terms of native grasses and native everything else, really. So I hope you're in the mood for caring and sharing. So if you need to wait, you do have drinks at 5 o'clock. But hopefully we'll be able to get rolling before that. First of all, I guess we need to be welcome to country before we start mucking around too much. And we're fortunate to have Jack Buckskin to welcome us to his country today. He has both Kaurna and Narunga lineage, and he's a cultural mentor at Taundi Aboriginal College. It's a crying shame that we haven't had a huge amount of Aboriginal culture that we've grown up with. I think of parts of New South Wales and Queensland, Northern Territory, where they have the privilege of being sort of really immersed in Aboriginal culture much more on a daily basis and so forth. But we'll give Jack a shot at welcoming you to his country. Thanks, Jack.
Thank you, Graham. How are we all?
Good.
Nice. I hope you want to be immersed in culture. Since we're going back to native everything, I'm going to get you all just to start taking away it now. Any of you don't know who I am, my name is really Vincent Buckskin, but my family call me Jack. Jack's nice and easy, but my Aboriginal name is Gunyungup Binapunawicha. That one's a little bit hard for people to get their tongue around as well, but I'm going to break it up for you. Ganya is my totemic name. Us as individual people, we all get our own individual totem. Mine, Ganya, which is the rock. And I asked my mum when I was young, I said, why did you give me the name Rocks? I knew you eventually was going to look like Ganya. No resemblance? And, you know what I'm talking about. But that's my title name, and what that does is it tells you that everybody has a part of our environment, and it's as equal as anybody else, which is what you're going to be talking about today. Everybody is an equal, and everything is the humans around it as well. As it is with our totem names, it comes down to being a part of the environment. My daughter, she is the black swan, so her name is Bulu. My name was Bulu, and the father of the black swan. And then I had a son, who's known as Mukul, which is the barking owl. So my name changed to Mukul, and the father of the barking owl. In a couple of months' time, a couple of weeks' time, we'll have our baby number 3. My name changed again, so that brings in Gani Mukul Pina. Goodnowitch Ed tells you I'm the third born male in my family. So we tell you exactly where we fit in that family when we first meet each other, because definitely Nate, you're the most important person. Normally the eldest in the family is the most important people, and my sister will constantly tell you that you're still the baby Jack. I told that live at the microphone. So Gani Nukapuna Goodnowitch, that's my name. I'm a representative of the Gurnee people of the Adelaide Plainfield and the Wurundjeri people from over on the York Peninsula. And again, Wurundjeri people from over near Stricky Bay. My dad is Egyptian Scottish as well, so I look a little bit like my dad. I started growing a beard for that very reason, not because I'm Muslim, but because my mum said I'm a constant reminder of how good looking my dad was when he was younger. So I grew a beard just to cover it up a little bit. And for me, this is one thing that I love to do is welcome people to my grandmother's country. I've lived here all my life, been lucky enough to relearn language, and I like to teach people that I'm the first generation in my whole family to be able to speak language freely and practice culture freely. So I walk over the country, I hunt regularly, not in sort of council though. Let's just say that anyway. If you've got any animals that you need to take care of. And for us, it's a massive thing. We dance, we do ceremonies all over the place, in our backyards. This part of the country is known as Muriaki, which is the dry valley as well. So on behalf of all of my ancestors and the Gurnee people that are still here today, and my family specifically from this part of the country, the Muriaki Whangkara, we'd like to welcome you to this part of the country. And I'm going to get you involved here, right? So, you put the pen down. Alright. You shake it out a little bit. Don't need to shake it out because I'm just going to clap myself. You know this one? You know what that means? Good. You got kids, haven't you? Yeah. Everybody got kids knows that one. Alright, so when I do this one, it means stop, and that means like stop immediately. Don't do an extra clap, let's stop. Somebody always falls for it though, does an extra clap, which is here we go. So I'm going to sing a song to our ancestors, country, on this country, to acknowledge them, and get them to bless us on country as well. So you got to follow along with me, yeah?